Given how divisive the European Union is for Tories today, it's perhaps ironic that an early advocate of union was the party's greatest leader.
We must all turn our backs upon the horrors of the past. We must recreate the European family in a regional structure, called, it may be, the United States of Europe. Therefore, I say to you, let Europe arise.
I got a text from Osborne saying good luck with Portillo, so he must have just been through your boudoir just now.
The Conservatives are divided even today on what Churchill thought and meant.
Well, Winston Churchill was very clear that the European Union might have its merits, but that Britain should have no part in it.
The Conservative Party clearly now has a very big problem with the question of the European Union. Do you think part of its origin goes back to this understanding or possibly misunderstanding of Churchill?
I think that both sides in the argument do invoke him, and he's tremendously important. He's talismanic. Winston Churchill, as you've just said, Michael, he called for a United States of Europe. But then what they don't say is that he then went on to say that Britain would have a separate relationship.
Boris isn't the only Eurosceptic who's invoked Britain's war leader, as this UKIP poster from 2009 shows.
How tremendously nice to see you.
Very nice
to
see you.
How
are you?
Very, very much. Lovely to see you.
But Churchill's grandson, and my former second-in-command at the Ministry of Defence, is outraged.
During the referendum campaign, every side claimed Churchill for their own. And it was a deeply embarrassing and lowering experience. I'm very glad that my mother wasn't alive to see it happening, because it was horrible, really. And I think the idea of, you know, Nigel Farage standing on the White Cliffs of Dover quoting Churchill is not the point of what it was all about. I don't think Churchill meant anything other than exactly what those words said, that he did envisage a kind of United States of Europe. There would have been no way that Britain could not have been part of that, by geography, by culture, by inclination, and everything else.
Why do you think the Conservative Party has had such difficulty with the European issue?
I think the Tory Party has never come to terms with the end of the last war. I think there is so much symbolism in our public life, and the symbolism of a kind of Britain alone doesn't fit with the Europe that has turned out to be.